Patsy White used to go on walks near Loma Linda with her friends and family. And this statement is something she told them, and it was corroborated by her granddaughter's husband, Elder Robinson. And as soon as he confirmed it, one of the brothers wrote it down, and I'm going to tell us about this, and he said, we need to know about this. So this is not written by Ellen G. White. It was written by friends of Ellen G. White that once they verified everybody was in agreement, they decided to write it down for us to know what she said. Okay? I'm going to read it to you. A statement by Ellen G. White, written by Elmer M. Johnson. Brother Will Ross, now deceased, was a personal friend of mine for about 45 years. In our church fellowship, we often spent Sabbath afternoons discussing the experience in the message and his conversations with Mrs. Ellen G. White. About 1908, while living in Loma Linda near Sister White, he frequently accompanied her in her walks and would discuss the message and the future events. On one of those occasions, while waiting at the railroad depot, in company with Sister McIntyre and Elder D.R. Robinson, her granddaughter's husband, Sister White related to the three of them about the storm of persecution that was about to burst upon Seventh-day Adventists. Brother Will Ross related to me as follows. This is in quotes. Sister White told us, as we three stood upon the depot platform, that the terrible storm of persecution was coming like a windstorm that blew down every standing object. There was not a Seventh-day Adventist to be seen. They, like the disciples, forsook Christ and fled. All who had sought positions were never seen again. After the storm, there was a calm. Then the Adventists arose like a great flock of sheep, but there were no shepherds. Kind of scary for me, huh? I'm a shepherd. There weren't any shepherds. They all waited in earnest prayer for help and wisdom, and the Lord showed answered by helping them to choose leaders from among themselves who had never sought positions before. They prayed earnestly for the Holy Spirit, which was poured out upon them, making them fully ready for service. That's the letter rain. They went forth fair as the moon, clear as the sun, and terrible as an army with banners to give the message to the world. I was astonished and asked if that applied to Loma Linda. As we were looking in that direction, but Sister White replied to my question that it applied to the entire denominational world. I was so stunned, I could not ask any more questions.